the mole and chemical equations. We've applied the mole concept to atoms and to molecules, and we can apply it to chemical equations as well. Here we have methane plus oxygen giving carbon dioxide and water. Very, very important reaction, because this represents the burning of methane, and another product in addition to CO2 and water is lots of energy. So every day we take advantage of this particular reaction. The numbers out in front, the coefficients, indicate the number of molecules that are reacting. So one molecule, two molecules produce one and two over there. But on a practical scale, it's a little more useful, a lot more useful, to use the mole concept. And we use those same coefficients now and interpret the equation in terms of moles. One mole of methane requires two moles of oxygen to give one mole of CO2 and two moles of water. Well, another way of interpreting this equation, in the past we've interconverted moles and molecules. Let's interpret the equation on this scale, the mole scale, but in terms of molecules. One mole, we know, is Avogadro's number, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. Two moles would be two times that. To give one mole of CO2, 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, MCS is my abbreviation for molecules. And over here, two moles, 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of water. A much more useful interpretation of this equation using the mole concept would be in terms of grams. One mole of methane we know is the molecular weight in grams. So we'd use the periodic table, the elements, look up carbon's atomic weight, 12.01, the hydrogen, add that together and we get 16.05 grams. Oxygen has an atomic weight of 16 times 2, would be 32, times 2 moles would be 64. Over on the right-hand side, when we add up CO2, we get 44.01 grams, 2 moles of water. Oxygen is 16, each of the hydrogens is 1, making 18 times 2, 36.04 grams of water. So that means that if we burn 16 grams of methane, we're going to get 36 grams of water, and so forth. An interesting fact is that if we total the number of grams of material on the left side, 80.05, we have, of course, that exact same number on the right-hand side. Under ordinary circumstances, we can't create or destroy matter. When an equation is balanced, it means that the grams will balance also. Let's work some problems now with these concepts. Remember, when we have a factor that we can work two problems, well, here we have a lot of factors. The number of variations that we could work would be 60 or 80, probably a huge, huge number of problems. The good news is we can work them all and work them in one step. Here are three problems based upon the equation that we just looked at. If we burn 1.30 moles of methane, how many moles of water form? Or we could ask how many molecules of water form, or how many grams of water form. If you were given a problem like this, you'd need the balanced equation, and typically that would be given to you. You aren't required to come up with the equations, but it would be given. And I hope that at this point, a couple of things go through your mind. As you see numbers up here, I'd like you to think, hey, here's a math problem. Do I have a formula for it? No, we don't have a formula. We're going to use the factor unit method to solve this problem. And in the factor unit method, we always have a starting point, which helps enormously. We write down the number that's given and couple it with the unit. 1.30 moles of methane. We leave some space. here's where we're going to put in the factor. And then from the reading of the question, we identify our goal. In this case, we'd like to know moles of water. So let's repeat those, but then fill in the factor now. It's always true with each one of these problems that we'll work, because we can work them in one step, the unit that goes in the numerator is going to be the same as the unit of the answer. So we'd like moles of water. And the unit in the denominator is always going to be the same unit that we're given, because we'd like it to cancel. So we've got moles of water over moles of methane. We get these numbers from the balanced chemical equation, interpreting it in terms of moles. All these numbers that we put down on the board just a minute ago, 2 moles, 2 was the coefficient in front of water, 1 was the coefficient in front of methane. Have 3 significant figures, 2 and 1, we're sort of treating those as exact numbers, so we'd have 3 significant figures over here on the right-hand side. Here we've gone from moles to moles. You can mix and match all sorts of possibilities. We could go from moles to molecules as well. Again, here's our starting point. We'd need molecules of water in the numerator because that's the unit of the answer. We need moles of CH4 in the denominator so that it will cancel. And using our balanced chemical equation and all the numbers that we derived, we had 1 mole, the coefficient in front of the methane. Molecules of water, well, let's see, what did we have? We had 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd. And now if we'd multiply 1.3 times 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd, we get 15.7 times 10 to the 23rd molecules of water. And typically we do one more step. We want to put the decimal after the first digit. If we do that, 1.57 times 10 to the 24th molecules of water. And finally, the third problem that will work, if we started with a certain amount of methane, how many grams of water will be produced? This certainly would be a useful kind of calculation in the laboratory or in industry. Again, we want to get rid of the units moles of CH4, so here it is in our denominator. We want the unit grams of water in the numerator because that's what we're after. We'd look back to our balanced chemical equation, interpret it in terms of moles, and the number of grams of water that we had was 36.04. And when we multiply now, we get 46.85 grams of water. Let's do one more equation for practice. This is a very useful equation in industry. Nitrogen plus hydrogen to give ammonia. Ammonia is a valuable fertilizer. Nitrogen very abundant in the atmosphere. And so this reaction is carried on in a huge scale. If 10.00 grams of nitrogen react, how many grams of ammonia form? Very typical kind of problem. And of course, we, by saying that it reacts, we're assuming that we've got all the hydrogen that we need for the reaction. If you saw this problem on a quiz or an exam, I'd like to have you think, hey, math problem, do I have a formula for it? No. We're going to use the factor unit method, and we'll just do the problem in one step. Here's what we've started with, 10.00 grams of nitrogen. Got the unit in there, be sure and put that in. Here's the unit of the answer that we'd like, grams of ammonia. And now we'd always be given this equation, has to be balanced. And we can interpret the equation in terms of moles, 1 mole, 3 moles, 2 moles. Well, the problem doesn't involve hydrogen, so we're not even going to worry about that. We're not going to generate those numbers. I don't see anything about molecules. We're not going to generate those numbers. We'll simply pull out the numbers that we need from the balanced chemical equation by using the coefficients as moles. I don't have moles here. I need grams of ammonia in the numerator. I need grams of nitrogen in the denominator. So the only thing we're going to use are grams. Let's just pull out those numbers and not derive all the other numbers. To get grams of ammonia, well, the coefficient tells us we have 2 moles. We'd look up the atomic weight of nitrogen, add 3 hydrogens, multiply it by 2, that gives us 34.08. We do the same thing with nitrogen. Nitrogen's 14.01, its atomic weight. We've got 2 nitrogens, that'd be 28.02. These are the numbers now. We'd multiply, and the answer comes out to be 12.16 grams of ammonia. We have 4 significant figures. One other thing that's nice to do, it's called approximation. You sort of look at the numbers and see if they make sense. Well, 34 over 28 is a little more than 1. A little more than 1 times 10, it's going to be a little more than 10. Hey, my answer's okay. Once in a while, you hit the wrong button on a calculator and you come up with a crazy answer. So it's nice to look back and just sort of approximate.